Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. For those of you who are first learning Photoshop, I'm going to show you how to create a simple white text design on a light pattern background. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl N on Windows or Command N on a Mac. Make the width 1550 pixels, the height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Click the lock icon to unlock the layer. Now we can add filters to it. Double-click the thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Pattern Overlay and open the pattern thumbnails. Click the gear icon to open the flyout list of pattern presets and click Web Patterns. When you see this pop up, click OK to replace the current patterns with the web patterns. Click the gear icon and click Small List. Scroll to the bottom and click Dots 1. Reduce the opacity to 10% and click OK. Go to Filter and Lens Correction. Click the Custom tab and make the vignette amount minus 30. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Let's collapse the effects to consolidate space in the Layers panel. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a heavyweight font. I'm using Montserrat Bold. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make its size approximately 260 points. However, you may want to use a different size depending on the font you choose and the amount of characters you'll be using in your text. I'll make its aliasing sharp and left alignment. Click on the left of your document and type your first character. Open your Move tool and position the character on your document. We can always reposition it later. Click the FX icon and click Gradient Overlay. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Go to the lower left stop and drag it all the way to the left. Click the color box and in the brightness field, type in 80%. Then click OK. Click the lower right stop and the color box. In the brightness field, type in 100%. Then click OK on the color picker and the gradient editor. Make the style linear, the angle 180 degrees, and the scale 150%. Click Stroke. The size is 4 pixels, the position is inside, the blend mode is normal, and the opacity is 100%. Click the color box. The saturation is 0% and the brightness is 95%. Then click OK. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is Multiply and the opacity is 10%. The angle is 45 degrees. The distance is between 70 and 75 pixels, and the size is 40 pixels. Then click OK. Let's collapse the effects to save space. Go to Edit, Transform, and Skew. Go to the middle of the side and when you see a vertical double arrow, drag the transform up to skew it. Then press Enter or Return. Count the amount of characters that will ultimately comprise your text. For this example, since my text will spell out the word polar, the total amount of characters is 5. Since I already have the first character, I'll press Ctrl or Command J 4 times. Hide all the characters under your second character and double-click the large T of the second character to highlight it. Type the second character of your text. Open your Move tool, go to your second character, and press and hold the Shift key as you drag it to the right, allowing your first character to overlap it. Pressing and holding Shift kept the second character aligned as you dragged it across. Make the third character visible and double-click it to highlight that character. Type the third character of your text and open your Move tool. As before, press and hold the Shift key as you drag your third character to the right. Continue these steps for each character. If you want, you can make characters go on top or below the other characters. For example, if I want to move the letter L on top of the letter O, I'll go to my Layers panel and just drag the letter L above the letter O. If I want the R to be on top of the A, I'll drag the R layer above the A layer. Next, we'll center the text on your document, but first, make the top layer active and shift-click on the bottom character to make all of them active. Place them into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Now, just drag your text to the center. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.